Good morning, praise the Lord. Today, February 3rd, we'll talk about some deadly sins, because we should know what is sin, then only we'll be able to avoid it. John 8:34 says, "Whoever commits sin is a slave of sin." These are the words spoken by Jesus Christ himself, and so we have to give serious thought to sin and its consequences. In one church, when the pastor spoke strongly against sin, one of the members asked him not to speak so bluntly about sin because the youngsters in the church might be upset, embarrassed, and wrongly influenced. The pastor went to the medicine shelf and brought back a bottle which was labeled as poison. The pastor asked the member that if he should change the label and write peppermint candy, what would happen? The pastor insisted that he, like the Bible, should be plain about the tragic results of sin. Hope you understand this. Because if we don't know the consequences, we'll try to commit those sins which are against the Bible. Pope Gregory the Great, at the end of the 6th century, divided all sins under 7 categories. He said that every sin that a man commits can be classified by 7 words: pride, envy, anger, impurity, gluttony, slothfulness, and avarice. These have been called down through the centuries as the 7 deadly sins. These are not collectively mentioned in a single passage anywhere in the Bible, but they are all condemned separately in many places. For the next few days, we'll try to understand more about these sins, check ourselves to see if they are in us, and if they are, to get rid of them. Before we start this study, we should first make sure that there is no exception. Every one of us is a slave to sin from the day Adam disobeyed God. Paul in Romans 3:23 says, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God." If we don't get rid of our sins, there is no possibility of us going to heaven to be with God and share his glory. Secondly, we should confess our sins to God and renounce it. Thirdly, we have to open our hearts to receive his grace. Fourthly, we'll ask the Holy Spirit to come into our hearts to help us. Shall we? Lord, our Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord, for sending Jesus Christ to bear our sins and give us a way to heaven. Please help us to know what our sins are and help us to remove those sins from our hearts. In Jesus' precious name I ask. Amen. God bless you.